Welcome back to Fabric Tech Talk Fridays. I'm Patrick, and I'm here with my fantastic co-host, Swetha, for another exciting episode where we break down the power of Microsoft Fabric and show you how to use it effectively and efficiently. Today's topic is unlocking data analytics at scale with Microsoft Fabric. And let me tell you, this is a big one. As organizations collect more and more data, they need powerful tools to ensure visibility, governance, and optimization. We have our amazing guest with us, Gaston Cruz, who's not only a Microsoft MVP, but he is a data expert. And Gaston is not going to only talk about governance, optimization, but he's also going to provide us a demo with a real-world scenario.
Thanks, Patrick. Hey, everyone, I'm Swetha. And you're right, Patrick, today's episode is a must-watch. If you are handling large-scale data analytics and want to maintain visibility and control across your entire data estate, this episode is for you. I'm thrilled to meet you, Gaston. Welcome to the show.
Thanks, Patrick and Swetha. I'm super excited to be here today. And, you know, Microsoft Fabric is a game changer in terms of monitoring capabilities, governance, compliance, everything at scale. So I'm glad to be here.
All right. So let's get right into this. Scaling your analytics is more just about handling large amounts of data and big data. It's about understanding your data, understanding optimization, understanding what we're working with this data. And Microsoft Fabric has a lot of capabilities and tools directly built in. So Gaston, before we jump into this demo, why don't you share why monitoring and governance is so important?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, one of the biggest challenges around, you know, monitoring governance and all about the environments is talking about where is your data? What is the compliant? What is the sensitivity of labels? What is out of the box tools that we have across the Microsoft space? So we are going to be tracking, monitoring, ensure the compliance across the different spaces. How Fabric is connecting with Purview as one of the biggest deal. So I'm really excited to start showing what's going on in the Fabric environment.
That makes total sense, Gaston. Without proper governance, we all know that organizations can lose track of data movement and permissions, and even increase compliance risks. Now let's see that hands-on demo that you put together and see all of it in action. Enough of all this talking, Patrick. Let's get into the demo.
Let's get into the demo, Gaston.
Sounds amazing. Let's go over to my machine then and start sharing a little bit the insight. So there's more than a couple of, you know, out-of-the-box tools within the Fabric environment. First of all, let's try to familiarize with the admin portal. You have everything that you need to monitoring all the frameworks back there. But that is not just the portal itself. You can go further on that line with out-of-the-box tools like, you know, the Fabric capacity metrics, and you can go over to the Fabric metrics apps and start understanding, hey, what is my consumption level? What is my cost? And start understanding what are the workloads that you're leveraging across all the organization. Then you can have the real Purview you have. You have an embedded solution of Purview within, and you can check on sensitive levels, endorsements, how you're leveraging domains across business units, even checking the item explorer to check everything that happens in your Fabric environment. But at the same time, you can go and monitoring what's going on in your backend, how you're running your pipelines, your data flows, your domains, how you're tagging different items, and how you can explore your own data. As well, you have a whole future of usage and adoption, and you can understand how your users are tackling down the Fabric environment and understand what is the level of usage, what is the level of capacity that you're leveraging, and what are the workloads within Fabric that you're, you know, more leveraging from Power BI, Lakehouse, Data Engineer, Data Scientist, and so on. So this is an overview of all out-of-the-box frameworks within Fabric.
Wow. And all this is just built in. It just comes when you set up Fabric, when you start using the environment, when you start creating items and artifacts, it just comes out of the box. Now, we know Fabric is amazing and it has all these built-in capabilities, but what if I wanted to extend this? What if I wanted to create my own solution and extract some of that data and kind of customize it to meet my organization needs? Is that possible, Gaston?
That is a really great question, Patrick, and I'm really excited to show you that going back to my machine, and you can see a custom demo that we have across connecting to the semantic link, commenting to the REST API of Fabric, and you can leverage configurations, ETL, storage, semantic models, and Power BI reports. And just to give you an overview of this, you can create your own enterprise data dictionary, you can get all the tables, columns, measure, you can expose everything around that, you can understand what are the users' activities within your tenant, data set refreshes, all about catalogs, and as well, a bunch of different items that are connecting to your tenant to understand the whole process of users, adoption, and consumption in your Fabric environment.
Wow.
That is super helpful, Gaston. And what's really exciting is that Fabric makes the monitoring and governance tools accessible, even for the teams that might not have a dedicated data governance professionals.
All right, Gaston, for those watching who want to start implementing monitoring and governance in their own Fabric environments, what are the first steps they should take?
Go to your Fabric admin portal, understand the whole options within the portal, start thinking about governance settings, monitoring tools, and then second, go to the purview to start thinking about data cataloging, sensitive labels, and information protection itself.
That's huge.
This was an incredible session, Gaston. Thanks again for sharing your insights and expertise, showing us all the Fabric monitoring and governance capabilities in action.
That's a wrap for this episode of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays. Thank you, Sweta. Thank you, Gaston, for coming out and hanging out with us. Remember, there's still time to register for FabCon 2025 in Las Vegas. We'll be there. Stop by and say hello. A big thank you to everyone for watching this video. We really appreciate it. Remember, we make these videos for the community, with the community. If you like this video, be sure to hit that like button. If you have any questions or comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If this is your first time visiting the Fabric YouTube channel, smash that subscribe button. And as always, from Sweta, Gaston, and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you next Friday.